Lexi, do you know today is Wednesday hump day? I never heard of why you're laughing. I never heard of it.
Because Wednesday's always hump day.
I never knew. This is the first time I'm listening to the radio, really listening, and I said hump day, and I turned around to Papa, and I said, today's what?
Do you know what hump day means?
Hump day means you get over the hump of a Wednesday into the next day.
I wasn't thinking of over the hump. I was thinking of hump. Never knew about humping.
You have a filthy mind.
Yeah, I think I do.
Lexi, darling, this is your console. Come have a seat,
Hello.
My darling. This is Lexi.
Hi.
Hi.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
You too.
So what are we doing for you?
So I'm a professional mermaid.
You're a mermaid?
Yep, that's right.
I didn't know professional mermaid was a job.
When people hear that I'm a professional mermaid, they usually get really surprised or shocked. So I tell them that a professional mermaid's job is a mix of musical theater, acting, improv, free diving, and synchronized swimming all rolled up into one big ball. I'm doing a series of underwater photo shoots. So I was hoping that I could have some maybe out of this world, tropical, summer themed mermaid nails.
Okay, we can do that as long as there's no fish.
No fish. You don't have to do any fish.
All right, good, because I'm afraid of fish, so we ain't.
Really? I can introduce you to some of my fish friends.
No.
No?
No. They creep me out. Like, they creep me out, and, like, you're in the ocean, and, like, they're swimming around, and, like, I just don't like them. Mm-mm.
Mermaids really love sparkly things, so if there's a lot of bling involved, I'm there for it.
Okay, I got you. We got lots of bling here. Got it covered.
And with mermaids, a lot of the emphasis is movement and grace. So having some sort of movable parts to it would be really, really cool. Maybe like a mermaid tail that can flip its fins, or a volcano that might be able to erupt, something really outrageous and out of this world.
Oh boy.
I can't be like hooking up a battery to your finger with like electrical currents and then send you underwater because you're gonna get electrocuted. It's just not gonna happen.
Sounds good. I'm just gonna have to do a lot of thinking.
I wore my mermaid dress today,
okay?
I'm gonna, you know, bring out my mermaid vibes, but no fish. None of that. So right now I'm working on the sketch for these mermaid nails. So Sinead came in and said she's a professional mermaid, which I didn't even know was a thing. She wants to be glittery and sparkly and very tropical. She wants a moving tail. So I gotta find something to make like this kind of emotion. And then this volcano, I just don't think it's gonna be a good idea. I don't really know how this volcano fits with the mermaid. I don't get it. I don't get it. But she asked for a volcano, so I'm gonna try it. So I'm sculpting it out of acrylic, made my little volcano shape. It's just, a volcano is not aesthetically pleasing on an nail. It's just a brown blob. Okay, and if nothing is coming out of, like, spewing out of it, and there's no lava happening, it just looks like there's a poop emoji on your nail. Like, why do you want this on your nail? If you were going for emoji nails, then I'd say, yeah, sure, but we're going for mermaids. We don't want turds. It doesn't look good, and I'm not putting this on her nail. It's just not happening. Moving on, new idea. I'm gonna give her something that's so much better than that. Sinead said mermaids love bling. I'm gonna go with some sort of like blinged out treasure chest. I'm using brown acrylic and I'm gonna sculpt all the sides. So I sculpt the lid out of acrylic and now it's time to bling it out. We gotta put the treasure in the chest. Treasure chests need a lot of treasure. So I'm bringing the treasure. We're bringing the bling. She wants some sort of interactive element besides the tail. I figured some sort of like clam, oyster, opening, closing. I don't know which one has a pearl in it. I'm gonna make the seashell that opens and closes with a pearl in it on her nail. To make the clam open and close, I'm gonna use a hinge. So I'm gonna sculpt the top shell and the bottom shell around this hinge so you can physically open and close the clam shell and see the pearl. Clamster. So now I gotta create some sort of sand-colored acrylic for the sandcastle. Once I have the color for my sandcastle, I'm gonna use my little handy-dandy brush and I'm gonna sculpt the shape of the sandcastle. I don't know, I hate the sand. I just hate it. I don't like the sand. I don't know. It gets in places that you can't get it out of. I don't like it. It gets on you. It just never leaves. It's like herpes. Like, you can't get rid of it. Once I got the sandcastle sculpted, I added the flag. I added my little shovel. I added some glittery sand mixture. And I'm liking it. So Sinead is coming in tomorrow for these mermaid nails. And I'm not done. I'm the only one at the salon to keep the business moving. So I'm in here today, you know, just me, the huge, working away in this little cave of mine, trying to get this thing done. All right, so next, we gotta make a tail that moves. I got a flat shape first, and I'm gonna use colored acrylic to sculpt the shape of the tail. We're at the tail end of this, okay? So we just gotta get this done. So I really don't know how I'm supposed to get this tail to move. If Sinead is underwater, like, I can't use a motor, I can't use a magnet. I don't know what I'm supposed to do at this point. I really don't. I think we hit the tail on the head. If Sinead is swimming, the tail should be able to move back and forth with the pressure of the water, as long as I put it on some sort of a hinge. I'm using the hinge for my little clam shell. Why not use a hinge for the tail? Because it does this. I'm gonna use some more colored acrylic to build up a 3D shape. Add some more bling on it, and let's hope this tail moves. Moving mermaid tail. We got this. Let's hope she likes them. I'm out of here. Is that thing like heavy carrying that around?
It's not as bad. It's 23 and a half pounds, but you get used to it.
That's a lot. Sinead comes in today, she's got her tail, we've got the nails. I just hope everything's cohesive and everything just goes together. Okay, set your fin down, you know, stay a while.
I asked Lexi for a set of out-of-this-world tropical mermazing nails with bling, an erupting volcano, and treasure and sparkles, and something that moves.
That's awesome. Is there anything else you want to say?
I can't wait. I'm giggly about the gills to see what she's made for me.
Okay, so let's get these on you.
All right, can't wait.
Okay.
Whoa. That is so cool.
Yes, we got a little clamshell here.
It opens, whoa.
Yeah.
Perfect.
Got your sunset, we got the bling.
Oh, I love that. Oh my gosh, is that a sandcastle?
Yes.
That's so cute. Whoa.
You said mermaids love their treasure.
Oh my God. That's amazing.
You've got some treasure. Okay, and we have one last nail to put on.
Okay.
So are we ready for the tail?
Yeah, I'm ready.
We have a tail.
Whoa. This is insane. Lexi, oh my God. That's amazing.
The moving tail nail, I think, is the most magical piece. It looks just like my mermaid tail with the colors and the scale pattern and everything. It's amazing.
I absolutely love these. Thank you so much for making all my mermaid dreams come true, Lexi.
All right, so we got the nails on. I think we need to try on this tail.
Yeah, let's tail up.
Okay, good. Well, I will help you so we don't, you know, break the nails. I wear a lot of strange things. I shock a lot of people. I've never seen anything like this in my life.
I've never seen anything like these in my life either.
So it's new for both of us.
This is crazy.
There's a mermaid, full-blown mermaid in the salon. And no one's here to see it but me. The salon is empty, which means there's no other money coming in besides me.
How do you move that thing around?
You have some pirates help you.
Oh, all right, I can get down with that.